basically the building up of a network or a business or putting your name out there or basically building up your business around you who just, you know, you're in your, well, just started your second month,
yeah.
trying to build up a business around you versus, you know, somebody that's been in the business for 10, 20, 30 years that has a network of clients and things like that. So what's kind of your thoughts on that? What are you, what have you been challenged with in the month that you've been in real estate? What are you foreshadowing? What do you think your biggest struggle is going to be? What do you think something that you are going to excel at? What would that be?
Well, I guess I've definitely, I knew starting out that it will probably take, you know, it'll snowball up. So the first year is going to be a little slower. Each month might pick up a little more. It's because, you know, people don't know me. That's why I tried to start my social media off before I had my license, just to get my name out there. I guess it has been a little more difficult than I expected. I had this idea in my head that I would, you know, post on my social media, I got my license, and have people be like, oh, well, you know, not flocking to me, but, you know, like I expected that it would be more of a turnout, which I realize looking back on it, like it makes sense that it hasn't been. And I think the recognition I have gotten was because I'm lucky enough to have a mentor. Like, you know, you give me shout outs all the time and stuff, and almost every bit of recognition that I've gotten, if someone mentions it to me, is because of you or because John's been telling everyone at the gym. But I'd say most of it is I've had a lot of people, more than I expected, say, oh yeah, I listen to your podcast, and I'm just like, oh, like surprised by that. But I think probably like most sales jobs, it's just going to take time, especially because this isn't like, you know, I'm not selling cars, which I think probably, you know, people need cars more frequently than buying a house.
In traffic too.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. I know it's going to build up and take time, but I think like, you know, 3 years from now, when I look back, I'm going to be grateful for, you know, I go to a lot of events now. Every time Brittany texts me about an event, I make myself go there. Even if, you know, after my other job, I want to go home and take a bath. But I think, 3 to 5 years from now, I'm going to look back on that and be really grateful that I'm doing it. Because at this point, it's just, you know, people don't know me. And, you know, if they're buying something as big as a home, they want to do it through someone they trust. And at that point, I'm just building, you know, making sure that people know who I am and knowing that I'm not, you know, going to do something sleazy. Yeah, I guess that's my challenge right now.
Yeah, I think so. When I started, which was funny, was one, I grew up in the area, so I have that advantage over you. Meaning, you know, you don't have any contacts for the most part. You do
have
contacts.
A handful, yeah.
Yeah, but it's not. You don't have like a childhood location that you can. I mean, you could. You can go back to Blackwater, Rock, wherever you forgot wherever you Black something where you grew up.
Black Lake
in New York. I probably never get that right. I always end up saying something completely wrong. It's just the idea of like when I first got in, I was 21, whatever the age was exactly. But I got in, nobody as peers of mine were buying homes. Actually the first person that ever bought a home was an a classmate of mine in high school. She bought a piece of land. I think that was my first deal I ever did. It was cool that she was able to buy it at a young age. But I went a lot of times with no clients, and it wasn't like I knew a lot of people. Back then I didn't do a good job of getting out into meeting people.
Yeah.
I was very, you know, I just kind of floated, and I was part-time in college, and I didn't really understand the idea of, building relationships with people. So I didn't do that.
Yeah.
And most of my business came from me calling leads that I had no relationship with, at the time, a very limited amount of skill set on how to actually like know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Now I'm very confident. I can be on the phone with pretty much anybody, and I have almost a decade of trial and error behind that. I don't know, goes through my brain somehow and filters out what to say and do and where to steer the direction or to help out the person as to what their needs are. But when I was starting out, I didn't have any of this at all. I really was just, you know, I'm just going to put some effort into it. Now, granted, back then, I wasn't, you know, even only being 5 years younger than you are now, it was a different point in my life. You know, you're at a different point than I was at 20. I would say, well, and now I've gotten to the point over 9 years of just slowly, and I call it the snowball effect, is that me at 21 knew very little amount of people. Well, guess what? By the time I was 22, I knew more people.
Yeah.
By the time I was 23, I knew more. And then it started to get to the point where, like, 24, I started to have some peers or kids that were a couple years older than me start to dabble in getting into buying homes. I was meeting some people here and there, and it kind of led. Now I'm getting to the point where I know a lot of people, and a lot of people that I don't even know me, which is cool, which is kind of leveraging my social media channels and things like that. And then I've also, obviously, through networking, I'm getting more referrals and getting repeat business. I've gotten over that, like, 7-year hump where I've actually had people that are bought when I first started and now are turning around and selling and moving up or buying and downsizing or whatever the case may be. But it's, you know, it's a slow build. So, and we talked about this when you got in the business. It's not like kind of what you just said. Yeah. Like, hey guys, I'm on social media. I'm Ellie. I'm selling real estate. Everybody come list their home with me. Like, I still to this day am always prospecting for people.
Yeah.
And that's something I've never stopped, and I don't think I'll ever stop doing it, because you have to. Some facet, I have to do it. And I'm even getting to the point now where I'm prospecting not for me as an individual agent. I'm not, or relationships not as an individual agent, but how is it going to benefit the company long term? Yeah. Like, how is stuff I'm able to connect with now going to bring in extra business that I can't handle that now can get trickled out to the rest of the team to grow their businesses?
Yeah.
And that's something I've really, over the last year, have kind of shifted my focus to. That's cool. Like, I think I could sell. I think I can really expand what I'm doing personally, but I've gotten to the point where how can I expand myself while also trying to build up as many people as possible that are brand new or existing agents that have come to our company. How can we work on building up a company versus one person? Meaning, but I think my idea for my recommendations, I kind of jotted down a few of them, like, hey, Ellie, or someone in Ellie's position, here's some things that I think you could do, or that I would do. Again, hindsight, knowing here I am nine years into it, what I would have probably changed the first couple years that I didn't do, that I didn't really start doing a lot of these things until probably 3 or 4 years ago, which slowed up my process, but also gave me a little bit of learning time. The first thing is utilize your friends and family. Yep. Reach out, let people know that you're in real estate.
Yeah.
Let me know, let Brittany know, let any other person you know, let your coworkers know, let the people you go to the gym know, which I would tie into John.
Yeah.
You know, obviously if you have a spouse or a significant other that can be an advocate for you, you're not going to have a bigger advocate than your spouse. So I'm hoping John wants people to use you.
Yeah, he better.
but John obviously is in a position where he can see a lot of people. So that's a good niche. I actually, my gym has been a good, I would say, I guess, niche in the sense I've met a lot of people through the gym, and I've actually done a lot of deals with people in my gym, not necessarily from a, like, trying to get that business. I know it's kind of weird not trying to get that business, but by not trying to get that business, I got that business just through mutual and genuine friendships that I built. And then all of a sudden, 2-3 years later, they're like, hey, actually, I actually want to buy a home now. Oh, yeah, sure. I'll definitely help you out. Like, while we're sitting there sweating and doing, you know, working out next to each other, they're like, oh, by the way, I want to do this. I'm like, oh yeah, I forgot. I actually am in real estate. Yeah, we can do that. You know? And so that's helped, but I think that will be a good niche market for you. Utilizing friends, obviously networking opportunities. I didn't start going to networking till about 2 years ago, which is crazy to think about, because it's such a big part of my life now that I never did that.
Yeah.
You're doing it right from the start, which is phenomenal. Mentor, which you talked about.
Yep.
Basically watch what I do and learn what I do and basically mimic, and then obviously put your own spin on it, but just kind of see what I've been able to do or what I do, and then kind of pick and choose what you think is fits your style or not. And it's going to be open to the Ellie-ism that you want to put on it to make it your own, but to, you know, find a mentor and really learn from them. The next one I have is leveraging social media, leveraging this podcast. Obviously this is going out to multiple listeners. I think we just hit 400 plus downloads in like 3 weeks, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I don't know where that ranks, but it just sounds like a lot of people downloading it, which is neat. But leveraging, say, the podcast, leveraging social media. We've talked about leveraging each other's social media.
Yeah.
Tagging, sharing, commenting, liking, really, really using other people and other platforms. And we've done this very good, I think, through ADKYP.
Yeah.
It's a lot of those people in different businesses are giving shout outs to other people or making sure they tag them or making sure they put them out. So now their sphere can also see, oh, hey, that guy from the mortgage industry, that guy from insurance, that gal from, you know, the recruiting area. Oh, they're all like, oh, they all know each other. Oh, they're all cool people. Oh, they all seem like they're really genuinely good at their job and somebody I want to do business with.
Yeah.
Which you've done. So you're doing a lot of these things. And obviously, I think obviously leads and what you can generate, but then overflow of business. Like, you know, I've gotten to the point now where I can't do everything. I've business wise, I'm just kind of, I'm limited time wise, but you're able to pick up, I would say, like the overflow of, hey, I can't get to this. Can you do it?
Yeah.
And that's how I started my career. It was like, I'll go do the not so good listings or not so good showings, but guess what? It snowballs up and
It's experience.
Like, I'm not even close to where I want to be, but when I look back, I'm like, I've accomplished quite a bit over 9 years.
Absolutely, yeah.
So what is the next 9 going to be? Which is, as we know, a snowball. It exponentially gets bigger. You know,
looking good.
Yeah, it gets bigger on every year. It gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and it gets bigger quicker. So, but the last thing I think, out of all those things, if you can accomplish that, and again, this is for newer agents or even agents that are just starting out, is you have to be consistent. And the consistency part, whether it's prospecting, whether it's going to networking events, whether it's meeting people and introducing yourself to people and, you know, telling people that you're in real estate, not annoyingly, not being like Ellie in real estate, but, you know, bring it up in conversations that you do real estate, because it will lead to stuff. And posting on social media, it's just be consistent. I see a lot of agents that they'll do a couple good posts here and there. They'll do maybe a video and all of a sudden it's like crickets for 3 weeks or a month or 4 months. And they'll do something else. Like, that's one thing I really try to pride myself on, is that every day I'm putting content out. Every day I'm trying to add value to anybody that's following me, whether it's through podcasting, whether it's through video, whether it's through picture on my Instagram. But people are able to see that and hopefully get some kind of benefit, whether it's directly to real estate. Maybe it's just like a good funny post. Maybe it's something that's interesting. Maybe they hate me and somehow follow me because all they want to do is talk shit about me. But at the end of the day, you're still watching my stuff, so I don't care. It's all good. Would you agree? I mean, on those things, I think you've done pretty well. Like, you're on track. Like, it's not like Ellie's never done this. Ellie's doing this, but it's a slow...
It's taking time.
It's a slow build. You're 1 month in. So, like, I usually prepare people. You know, you may not sell a home for 6 months, and that's actually normal. Like, that's not, like... it's different. And on like a car business where people actually walk into the dealership to go buy a car.
Yeah.
People that want to see homes are usually reaching out directly to their agent they want to use. Yeah. So, you know, how do we get people to call Ellie?
Yeah.
If you guys are looking to buy a home, call Ellie.
please.
But yeah, how would you do it? You would call that person directly. And I think, you know, this kind of stuff, I didn't have this 7 years ago. I mean, granted, we're not this huge production. It will be at some point, probably.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
It'll grow, or at least it'll grow an audience size. But I think that's something that will help you, will leverage you. That's why we're doing it. That's why I'm not just doing a weekly real estate show about myself. That's why I brought Ellie on, because I, you know, two heads
Lucky
are better
me.
Than one. Yeah. But I think that's cool. Do you have anything to add on that, or do you think it's kind of?
No, I think that was, you nailed it. I think personally, the biggest thing that is going to lead to my success is having you and having someone who is going to basically like baby step me through the whole process instead of just kind of blindly going through and hoping for the best, basically.
I think the biggest thing is effort. You got to put forth the effort. I actually have it up on my board. Effort, if you can see right there, Ellie, effort is controllable, meaning there's only so many things you can control.
I can't find it.
Because of those glasses?
Yeah.
If you go up... Okay, it's right middle crack, just to the left, about four up.
Okay, I see it. Yep.
So
controllable.
Controllable. Yep. Effort is controllable, meaning that there's a lot of things we can't control in life, and I try not to dwell on good or bad, or if, you know, somebody calls me and says something happened at the home inspection or something happened right before about the close or something that's like out of my control, it's like, okay, well, what's the problem? How can I fix it now?
Yeah,
okay,
what's
next? A problem. Okay, shoot, this, you know, here's a little speed bump and some extra time in my day, but how are we just now? I don't want to dwell on it. I don't want to wish it didn't happen. It happened. Okay. How are we going to move forward? Just because that's the quickest way to resolve it. But again, it comes down to effort. What's controllable to me, your effort that you put in, your attitude, all that stuff's controllable. I really believe that. I try not to dwell on negative thoughts, negative people, negative situations, try to be positive.
Yeah.
Try to spread positivity to the people that I deal with and try to surround myself with like-minded people. And that seems to help.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, which I think you will. You have that
drive.
you have that effort quality.
Yeah.